Hi, my name is Dominik Drexler and this is Joint Work with Hendrik Seib and Hector Geffner about expressing and exploiting the common subworld structure of classical planning domains using sketches. In this work, we address the classical planning problem where we are given a planning task that consists of a domain and instance information. The domain consists of predicates and action schemas over these predicates, and the instance information consists of objects occurring in the instance and two sets of ground literals, the first one describing the initial situation and the second one describing a goal situation. The objective is to find an action sequence that, when applied to the initial situation, brings us to a goal situation. The key search component that we're using is the iterated width algorithm, or simply IW, which works well if the goal consists of a single atom. If the goal consists of a conjunction of atoms, then the serialized iterated width algorithm, or simply SRW, decomposes the problem into smaller subproblems by using a sequence of IW searches, each decreasing the number of unsatisfied goal atoms. In this work, we look closer into why SRW fails if it fails, and if it fails, we make use of richer problem decompositions by making use of a language of policy sketches. We propose a compact policy sketch for each domain coming from a selection of tractable classical planning domains. And we show that the SRWR algorithm, when equipped with such a sketch, is capable of solving a large class of planning problems in low polynomial time. The iterated width algorithm with parameter k is a breadth first search where a newly generated state S is pruned if the novelty of the state is greater than k. The novelty of a state S is defined as the smallest size of tuple of atoms made true for the first time. The IW of k algorithm requires time that is exponential in k. Typically, for k equals 1 and 2, IW of k runs fast, while for other k it runs pretty slow. The question then is, when does IW of k solve a problem? Underlying the IW algorithm is the notion of width. The following definition of width is not too important to understand the rest of the talk, but still I want to give some impression of how the width is defined. The width W of p of a problem p is the minimum k for which there exists a sequence of atom tuples t0 till tm, each consisting of size at most k atoms, such that the following three conditions are satisfied. The first condition is like a base case, which says that the tuple t0 is true in the initial state of p. The second one is the inductive case, which says that all optimal plans for the tuple ti can be extended into an optimal plan for tuple ti plus 1 by adding a single action for all I equals 1 till m minus 1. The third condition, saying that the last tuple in the chain implies the goal of the problem. So if pi is an optimal plan for tuple tm, then pi is also an optimal plan for p. And together with the definition of width comes two theorems. The first one saying that if there is such a sequence t0 till tm, then the IW of k algorithm is guaranteed to expand one underlying optimal plan. And the second one saying that if the width of the problem is smaller than k, then the IW of k algorithm solves p optimally in time exponential in k. So if the width of a problem is large, one way to solve the problem is by cutting it into smaller pieces of small width. Previous work has shown that a problem with a single goal atom often has small width. But of course, we often want to use more expressive goal formulations. For example, a problem with conjunctive goals often has unbounded width. But there is an extension of the IW algorithm called serialized iterated width, or SIW, which can still solve these problems. And the SIW of k algorithm runs a sequence of IW of k searches, each IW search decreasing the number of unsatisfied goal atoms, or simply decreases the goal counter. And here each subproblem typically requires achieving a single goal atom, which often has small width. But still, the SRW can fail, for example, if it traps into an unsolvable state, or it generates a subproblem of greater width. For example, it achieves a goal atom that must be undone to achieve the overall goal of the problem. And third, the subproblem has too large width. And here policy sketches come into play. Policy sketches is a language for defining richer problem decompositions that we are going to look into next. A policy sketch, or simply called sketch, often denoted with the symbol R, is a set of rules of the form CE over features phi. C is a set of feature conditions and E is a set of feature effects. A sketch R defines subproblems by defining subgoals in every problem P and Q. Note that we are now using a whole class of problems Q over some common domain. So a sketch aims at solving a whole class of problem over a common domain. The sketch width WR of Q is then defined as the highest width of all subproblems in all problems P in Q. And the SIWR algorithm serializes according to the subgoals defined by a sketch R. So for example, SIWR starts an IW search in the initial state until it finds a state that is defined as a subgoal by the policy sketch. And then from this state, it runs another IW search to find a state that is defined as a subgoal by the policy sketch and so on until it finds the overall goal of the problem. And the theorem from previous work tells us that if the sketch width is smaller or equals than k, then the SIWR algorithm solves all problems p and q in time that is exponential in k. So if k is 1 or 2, then SIWR solves this problem very quickly. Some special cases are: if the sketch is empty, then the sketch width corresponds to the highest width of any problem P and Q. And another special case is if the sketch R contains a single rule over the feature that counts the number of unsatisfied goal atoms, and the rule decreases the number of unsatisfied goal atoms, then the SIWR algorithm mimics the standard SIW algorithm. Let us look at an example sketch for the grid domain. In the grid domain, we are given a grid of places. A robot, a set of keys, and a set of locks are distributed over the grid. The robot can move around except for places that contain a closed lock. But if the robot is standing next to a closed lock and holds the correct key, it can open the lock, making the place available. The objective is to move keys to respective target locations, possibly having to open locks to make more places available. The SIW algorithm fails because it generates subproblems of large width. For example, it moves a key to a target location, but later on it has to pick up the key and open some closed lock. We consider four features. The first feature, locked, counts the number of locked places. The second feature, G, corresponds to the usual goal counter and counts the number of keys that are not at their respective target location, or in other words, counts the number of misplaced keys. The third feature, key lock, is true if the robot is holding a key that allows it to unlock a place. And the fourth feature is true if the robot is holding a key that is misplaced. Let us first consider the first two sketch rules. The first sketch rule says that if there are locked places, then decrease the number of locked places, or in other words, unlock places, while possibly changing the other features arbitrarily, meaning indicated by this question mark. And the rule R2 says that if there is no locked place anymore, but there are misplaced keys, then decrease the number of misplaced keys, or in other words, move keys to target places. And this exactly fixes the problem of SIW generating subproblems of large width. And we can also prove that the width of the sketch for this whole class of problems is 2, meaning that SIWR solves this problem quite efficiently. But we can do even better if we also consider rule R3 and R4, which further decompose the problem into more fine-grained subproblems. So the rule R3 says that if there are locked places and we are not holding a key that allows us to unlock it, then pick up a key that allows us to unlock a place. And the fourth rule, further decomposing the subproblem generated by rule R2, saying that if there is no locked place anymore, but there are misplaced keys, then pick up a key that allows us to move it to, that must be moved to a target location. And we can prove that the width of this sketch then has a width of 1, meaning that it is very efficient in solving the whole class of problems. Let us look at an example sketch for the Barman domain. In the Barman domain, we need to serve a set of cocktails. The recipe of each cocktail consists of two ingredients, and a cocktail can be produced by pouring both ingredients into a shaker and shaking it. Afterwards, we can serve the cocktail by pouring it into a shot. The SIW algorithm fails because the subproblem of serving a cocktail has large width. So this is an example where achieving a single goal atom has large width. The sketch decomposes the problem in a quite intuitive sense. So rule R1 says that if there's no first ingredient in the shaker that allows us to produce an unserved cocktail, then pour it into the shaker. And the second one rule says that if there's already a first ingredient into the shaker, then pour The second ingredient into the shaker that allows us to produce an unserved cocktail. And rule of three says, whenever we use a shot that must be used to serve a cocktail, then we should clean it. And rule of four says that whenever there is an unserved cocktail, well, then serve it. So this typically does the job of shaking the shaker and pouring the cocktail into the shot for serving it. And we can prove that the sketch width over this whole class of problems is 2. So this sketch solves the whole class of problems very efficiently. We also ran experiments with our sketches. First of all, we compare against domain-independent planners, which is not quite fair because our planner is domain-dependent. But still, this shows some nice things about sketches. So SRWR solves all domains, so 7 of 7. The SRW algorithm solves 0 of 7 domains. Llama solves 5 of 7 domains, and dual BFWS solves 4 of 7 domains. We can also see when looking at the time column that SRWR solves these domains quite effectively. And so sketches can go a long way in solving large classes of problems. We conclude that sketches are domain general, meaning that they allow solving large classes of problems. Sketches can compactly encode the subgoal structure of many classical planning domains. And the SRWR algorithm solves many domains in provably low polynomial time when provided with a suitable sketch. In future work, we want to learn sketches automatically, which allows us going from the domain-dependent to domain-independent setup. And we currently want to do this using unsupervised from samples and combinatorial optimization using answer set programming, but we don't have any results so far. Thanks for listening.